Hello everyone, good morning all of you. How are you all? I hope you all well. So let's start today's lecture. So today we are going to start lecture number 3 of chapter 7, and we have already done the lecture number 1 and 2 of this chapter. So before we start today's lecture, some discussed important points which we have already done in lecture 1 in lecture 2. So in lecture number 1, we have already studied about the two major problems related to India and Pakistan existence. Then we study about the merger of Hyderabad, Junagadh and Kashmir, and these three state was a biggest state, and there were not except United India. Then we have discussed in detail in these three topics, Hyderabad, Junagadh and Kashmir. And Kashmir is important for examination. Then we talk about the merger of French and Portuguese colonies. In this, all numerical information like date and years are important, and also important the merger of Diu, Daman and Goa. Diu, Daman and Goa. Write a short note on merger of Diu, Daman and Goa. It is most important for the examination for the 2 and 3 marks. So you have to write at least 4 to 6 point in examination. Then we discussed about formation and reorganization of Indian state. So we have seen that 4 types of classification of state: class A category, B, C and D. And Mumbai, Assam, Andhra, Punjab, UP, Bihar, Madras, Orissa, West Bengal were included in classification of state class A. Then Jammu, Kashmir, Hyderabad, Mysore, Central India, Rajasthan, Saurashtra, Travancore, Cochin and Papsu. Currently it is known as Patiala and East Punjab state of unit is included in class B. Then Ajmer, Bhopal, Coorg, Delhi, Bilaspur, Kutch, Himachal Pradesh, Tripura, Manipur and Vindhya Pradesh are included in class C, and the Andaman and Nicobar Island were included in class D. But after some times, these all classification went amendment and 2 parts are done. Then we studied about the other related important points, like on 1st May Gujarat and Maharashtra state separated, and on 25th May 1960 recognition of Maharashtra as a state was made and its capital Mumbai. Then Assam, Meghalaya, Manipur, Tripura, Arunachal Pradesh, Mizoram and Nagaland were recognized as a land of 7 sisters. Please underline this point. Okay, done. Then 7 union territories: Chandigarh, Pondicherry, Lakshadweep, Daman, Diu, Dadra and Nagar Haveli, and 1 national capital, that is Delhi. Then we study this map, and also I gave a homework. Okay, turn the map in map book. I hope you are done. Then we have discussed about regionalism, and in regionalism 2 main important factors are language, caste and religion. Then we discuss in lecture number 2 on this topic, and now we are start current topic, regional inequalities. Finally we start the today's lecture with new topic. Today's topic, regional inequalities. So what is regional inequalities? So we study in detail. The foreign rulers did not undertake development activities in place where they would not get any economical profit. What's the meaning of this? The foreign rulers did not undertake development activities where they would not get an economical profit. As a result, there was a regional inequality in such a place. Then after independence, the Planning Commission was formed for social and economic development of India. One of its main aims was the balanced development of different regions. Please underline the main aim of Planning Commission. It was the balanced development of different regions. What is the main aim of Planning Commission? So that was a balanced development of different regions. In fact, regional pressure, certain political reason, the tug of war to take development program to their own region, the maximum for development, etc. And the other factors play an important role in it. Therefore, the regional inequality is seen in matters of equal development. The resource of development grants give are the factors for regional inequalities. Mostly, development resource are grant the most factors for the regional inequality. As we see in this topic, like regional pressures, certain political reason, then development programs to their own regions. It is mostly maximum development for particular regions. So it is inequality between the different region. So first reason is for the regional inequality. Then the next para, even within the developed, moderately developed and less developed state, internal inequality exists, right? Any developed state or developing or less developed state, internal inequality we can see. So for example, Maharashtra is in category of economically developed, but it's a regional like Vidarbha and Marathwada are backward, right? Economically it is developed, but region like Vidarbha and Marathwada are backward. It is not a forward and a frank. So certain areas of Andhra Pradesh are well developed, while areas like Rayalaseema and Telangana are considerably backward. Backward with thinking, education, some customs, rules, etc. Some regions are ahead in agriculture development, while some region in industrial development. So in all the regions, different types of development are there. But due to that, regional inequalities arise. So there are many factors between the state which are quite visible for regionalism. There are some state who are at larger heights for the boundary issues, even though they are a part of India. Like between the Maharashtra and Karnataka, Punjab and Haryana, the boundary issue are still going on. Narrow-mindedness is seen in regions to acquire personal motive related to the flow of water and minerals, industrial raw material and agriculture sector. These regional inequalities and narrow-mindedness is a tremendous harmful to the unity of country. It is a very harmful to the unity of our country's unity. Means for preserving country's dignity, superior position should be planned rather than the taking interest in regional development. We give the importance to the country's development, not interest in a regional development. Then only we can preserve our country's dignity, right? I hope you all understand perfectly. So I give you 2 to 3 minutes as I give you all lectures, right? So now you have 2 minutes for reading, plus read the topic perfectly, because if you don't read, then you don't have any doubt, and if you don't have any doubt, then you don't clear in this topic. So please read it, and if you have any doubt, then you can ask me with the comment in YouTube channel. Okay, so your 2 minutes start. Okay, please read. Here is scrolling my screen. So last para you can read, which is on next page. Okay, done everyone. Okay, very good. Next topic, scientific and technological development. India has made extraordinary achievement in the field of science and technology in last half century. So students, in this topic, this table is most important for you. Other points is not that much important. So looking at reasonably limited resource and less literacy, India's growth in the field of science and technology in comparison with the other developed countries is unique. Right, India's growth in science and technical field is a unique with the comparison of other developed countries. So after independence, the distinguished national leaders and the scientists like Dr. Homi Bhabha, Dr. Raja Ramana, Dr. Vikram Sarabhai, C.V. Raman, and in the field of engineering, Ms. Sir M. Vishwaraya, Sam Pitroda, Dr. ABJ Abdul Kalam, India's former president. I hope you know, and it is must you know, because it is basic knowledge. ABJ Abdul Kalam, if you ask to any small child or little child, then he or she knows the name of ABJ Abdul Kalam. And now you all are in standard 9th, so you know the APJ Abdul Kalam. He was the former president of India and also the scientist and the creator of the successful metro railway project. Creator is Sridharana are those engineers, scientists and technocrats who had contributed remarkable in the field of science and technology. So Indian Institute of Science, Indian Institute of Technology IIT, Indian Space Research Organization ISRO, and Physical Research Laboratory are the glorious example. Women of India to play a noticeable role and below given in the list. Kalpana Chawla, Sunita Williams, these all are names we know, but some new names for us given here. Janki Amma, Flora Vegetation field mein. Then Azima Chatterjee, Chemistry field. Dr. Indira Ahuja, in field of Medicine. Then Shakuntala Devi, in field of Mathematics and Human Computer. Sorry, Shankuntala Devi. Then Kalpana Chawla, astronaut. Sunita William was also astronaut. And women of India have contributed at a large in other sector too, which brought further progress to our country. Students, these name and field is very important for examination, and it is very useful to you get good score and cash marks. So you read and also learn right now. You have 2 minutes for learn. See, I speak, I tell you, can learn this topic, not read. You have to learn right now. Okay? So this time, your time start now. If you speak loudly his name in full at least 2 to 3 times, then you can learn easily. I hope you all learn. Okay, learn. Good. At the time of independence, we were dependent on others for food grains. In making a self-reliant in this area, today, hogs, dams, lakes, canals have played a major role. We have been making use of modern agriculture technology to increase agriculture production for the country. And today, we export some food grains. Right? At the time of independence, we were dependent on other for food grains. And at now, the time is changed. And we export the food grains for other countries. So, now we are not dependent on other countries for the food grain. We have been able to achieve green revolution. Agriculture institutions, laboratories and agriculture university have been established to achieve growth in agriculture science. India has indeed made a significant headway in nuclear science and technology. India has established research institute and laboratories for peaceful purpose of its nuclear power. Nuclear scientists and engineers have constructed ultra-modern nuclear reactors and power station. By successfully conducting nuclear test twice a Pokhran in Rajasthan, we have been successful in making nuclear bomb. India's achievement in very short time in space research technology is a spectacular. We have developed a space shuttle, geosynchronous satellite launch vehicle to launch a satellite in outer place. We also have launched a satellite in outer space. Satellite like Aryabhatta in 1975, Bhaskar in 1979, Rohini in 1979, etc. useful in successful conducting nuclear tests in telecasting, education, weather, getting information about minerals through remote sensing system. In the last one decade, we have made a significant progress in field of telecommunication and information technology through computer, internet, mobile, smartphone, tablet, fax, email, Twitter, computer, WhatsApp, and so now India is considered in a race of developed nation. Please, students, tick mark this point. Aryabhatta, Bhaskara, Rohini, GSLV, then significant progress in telecommunication, computer, internet, mobile, smartphone. Please underline, hold the paragraph. Underline, please. The use of biotechnology in industry, energy, agriculture, health, and continuous research and development in that field have resulted in the maximum like Digital India and Make in India world famous. So, marine research and continuous development, human resource development and harbor development, including educational and health sectors too, are continuously involved in making progress. So, 21st June has been declared as a World Yoga Day by United Nations, which shows the glowing future of India. Please underline, 21st June has been declared as a World Yoga Day by United Nations. Here we done the unit, but please, you see this paragraph and read also. My motive is only that for the this reading, ki aap achche se read karoge, to hi aapko doubts aayenge. So I give my some times to you for reading. So please utilize this time properly. Okay, here on your screen, I provide the topics. Please read this topic for 2 to 3 minutes. Slowly scrolling the screen, and please tick mark the important points which will very helpful to you at the time of examination, because at the time of examination you don't have enough time to read all the lines. So at that time you see only the tick mark points which is important. Okay, please read this two para and turn this chapter. Then we some discuss related topic from exercise, and I give some homework and also questions which will you write in your fine note. And please, again I told you, sorry I tell you, submit your homework with your class teacher regularly. Please read. And this name of satellite is very important. And year is also important. 1975, 79, 79. 4 MCQ and 1 mark. And join the pair. Okay, done student. Okay, so first we go through the full chapter. It is a chapter at a glance. Okay, which type of topics we have done in this chapter. So first in starting, first important point is British Parliament handed over the India's independence at passed article for India's independence in 1947, and according to that article, two major problems before the countries there were: framing the constitution and put at the end to the sovereignty of British Empire on the princely state and merging them into making the impact India. Then we studied about the Hyderabad. The Nizam of Hyderabad with its state from southern part of India declares independence on 15th August. Then on 18th September 1948, using a police force, and ultimately Hyderabad was merged with the Union of India. Then Junagadh, mostly Nawab of Junagadh wrote an instrument of accession to join Pakistan. But at the last, on 9th November 1947, Junagadh was merged with the Union of India. Then Kashmir, in out of these three short note, Kashmir is important for examination. So please focus on this short note. Then merger of French and Portuguese colonies. In this merger of Diu, Daman and Goa, it is very important. See students, in my every lecture, I told you important points, important topics, and I revise all the lectures. Like in lecture number 3, we revision the lecture number 1 into both. So at last, the end of the particular chapter, we revise at least 2 to 3 times whole the chapter. So you can learn easily at home. Okay, so please students, please understood perfectly and learned perfectly and done your fan note timely. Then we discussed the formation and reorganization of Indian state, a classification of state main four types of class. Then some discuss in detail related to Maharashtra, Gujarat and other related states. Then seven sisters, land of seven sister, then Union Territories, then total 28 states. Then we done the map, state and Union Territories, and also the capital of state. They see, legend is a compulsory, you write in your paper. If you want right, then you don't get good score. Then regionalism. In regionalism, there are three main important factors: language, caste, and religion. Then regional inequalities. Some important reasons related to. Just a minute. My page will scroll. In regional inequalities. So in this topic, we studied about some inequalities in a development, like social development, economical development. So especially for the economic and social development of India, Planning Commission was formed, and one of its main aim was the balanced development of different regions. Then scientific and technical development. Many national leaders related we studied, like Dr. Homi Bhabha, Raja Raman, Vikram Sarabhai, C.V. Raman, A.P.J. Abdul Kalam, etc. And then we see the women's of India who play a noticeable role. Janki Amma, Azima Chatterjee, Indira Ahuja, Shankuntala Devi, Kalpana Chawla, and Sunita Williams. Then we have done this chapter. So you write exercise in your fan note, but you can skip the points which you already done in your homework, like on short note on merger of Goa, Diu, Daman, Hyderabad, Junagadh. So you can skip that type of question, like question number one, answer the following question. So question two and three, state of Junagadh Hyderabad merger and merger of Goa, Diu and Daman. So you already done in homework, so you can skip these two questions in exercise. Like this, you all mostly questions skip in your homework, but if you write written in your homework, then only you can skip in exercise. Otherwise, you have to write whole the exercise in your fan note. Okay. Green Revolution, Sardar Patel contribution is important for examination. Please tick mark. And MCQs is you write all the MCQ. Option is not important but obvious. So you write direct the answer and question. Okay. So today we done. Okay. From the next lecture, most probably we start geography. From the last two lecture we want to start geography, but it is not possible. But I hope from the next lecture we start the geography part, because in a history part we have already done three chapters, chapter number 1, 2, and 7, and in civics part we have already done chapter number 8, 9, 10, and 12. So we done four chapter in civics and three chapter in history. So from the next lecture we start the geography part. Till that you perfectly study these three chapters of history and four chapter of civics and complete your fan note, please. Okay. Goodbye, everyone. I hope you all enjoy today's lecture and understood perfectly. Okay, goodbye, everyone.